I wonder what all this looked like during the Ice Age.
Chilly.
It was quite impressive. A sort of barren grandeur. Enormous shapes everywhere, but not a sign of life.
Sounds like local government since reorganization.
Hey, I'm thinking.
Discovers language.
Bug off.
His very first words.
Do you mind? I'm trying to say something.
Then, out with it, small, scruffy person. Get it off your chest.
Forgot what it is now.
My God. Now, we should never know what fundamental breakthrough is about to creep out from under that hat.
My brain gets confused sometimes.
Never noticed that.
Hey, I wonder if Wellies rot your brain.
That's true. When you have seen the Nobel Prize for Science go to anybody wearing Wellies?
If you don't like them, why the hell do you wear them?
Sentimental reasons.
His mother used to wear Wellies.
Oh, only in the house.
Remember his mother? She was the kind of woman who could have inspired the inventor, the bulldozer. She once threw a red man at me.
That's a lie. She didn't throw him at me. I just had to be passing at the time.
And red men were much smaller in those days. Marvellous how they've recovered, really, when you think that red men were practically extinct during the Ice Age. It's wonderful how nature keeps a balance. Look at you two, for instance. He's the scruffy one with few natural advantages. And you're the one who's standing with your boot in all them sheep droppings.
My God.
What's up?
Steve has left a note.
A note? What the hell would he write to us for?
A suicide note, you muffin.
Hang about, Foggy. Maybe he's just swimming.
Can you see anyone swimming?
No.
Wonderful.
There's no note. Just a few dead meat pieces. I've just counted them.
Put them back. I bet your granny used to knit around the guillotine. Take her own sandwiches, front row of the stalls.
What's up now?
Remove your hat.
What good would that do?
It's gone.
Well, you're not lining up on him under my hat.
Somebody was going to think of that. Right, Lepman? You search downstream. Clegg?
Uh-huh.
Upstream. I hope he hasn't got spots or anything. Takes the edge off your perseverance with the kiss of life.
Maybe you could just hold his hand.
Do you see anything?
Just this great long from on the bank, scene. Can't you see anything?
Put your heads under, look for him. Those guys are close together. No, stay back, stay back. Poor devil just gone under.
Oh, dear.
They won't go in on four stomachs, you know.
Worst thing you can do.
My old filly is, poor chap was at the end of his tether. You get an instinct for these things, you know. I've got my chap to do for. Quite frankly, if he wants to go, I just kind of pull him back again. Sorry.
don't need to bother. I found it myself.
I make no apologies. It was all done with the noblest intentions in the service of humanity.
Well, I'm about to write, Prawn.
But think how you'd have felt if we'd saved his life, though.
Saved his life? We nearly killed him. Cheeky Mac nearly died of laughing.
It was very embarrassing, Foggy. I don't know why you had to tell him.
No, I wanted him to understand what a damn nuisance he'd been. Leaving his clothes lying on the bank like that. Wasting the time of the rescue authorities. Not to mention exposing us all to extreme personal danger.
Well, I thought you handled that dangerous dry land very well.
You'll be in danger, all right, you ever do that again. I can't bear having my loins in cold water. Everything shrinks so.
Stuff in our veins.
Not to mention pneumonia.
Ready to answer the call whenever it comes.
What call?
The call of danger.
Well, must be a wrong number. They are, look.
Oh, thank you, now.
In the service of humanity. Flask of hot, sweet tea.
Oh.
Aspirins, hot torch and battery, assorted splints, and emergency surgical instruments.
What's these emergency surgical instruments?
Well, at the moment, it's a Swiss Army penknife and a bent spoon.
Oh. Well, that's pretty comprehensive.
It's funny, see, we can build our equipment up as we go along, but I mean, this will do to get us started.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, there's practically no emergency known to man that you can't alleviate with a Swiss Army penknife and a spoon.
Hey, what I want to know is, where did you get that spoon?
It's my old army spoon, madam.
Yes, well, it had better be. Ours are all counted.
Not that we begrudge the odd spoon. The service of humanity.
I think the only part of humanity that wants servicing is that lot.
They left the Florence Nightingale.
I should think so if all she had was a bent spoon. Oh, it's the fairy queen.
Where does he think he's going, dressed like that?
Wherever there is need, madam.
You'll get locked up.
He's become a figure of hope to all in pain. As soon as practicable, I shall dress you two in the same uniform. Neat, but not gaudy.
Imagine the same uniform.
He's not getting me in any Superman outfit.
But he can't go turning up to the scene of an accident looking like that. He'll be upstaging all the victims.
Superman is from Yorkshire. We should have known.
Spirits in the river might have fired your enthusiasm.
It really fired our enthusiasm.
We are in the rescue business, the noblest of professions, saving decent little people. The others we can throw back. Now, but seriously, though, did it excite you in the water? Didn't you feel anything?
I did. Something wriggling in my welly.
Do you know what I felt?
Wait.
I felt useful. Just for once, we were doing something important, helpful. And it came to me in a flash.
So did that thing in my welly.
This is what we ought to be doing with our lives. Come on your feet. On your feet. You feel different when we've really rescued somebody.
If it's all the same to you, Foggy, I had planned to fritter my life away harmlessly.
Oh, not good enough.
Well, just thought I'd mention it.
No, a man's going to have some purpose in his life.
What's wrong with me here, funny women?
Judging by the way you look, they're not to be recommended. Come on, everyone. Keep your eyes open. We're looking for something that will help us to reach out to anyone struggling in the water. Right, now, if we find anything, we'll take it back to the canal side and leave it there ready for any emergency. That's it.
I know, ladder.
Here we are. We have to improvise. You know, we haven't got the resources available to the authorities. We have to make do.
Yeah, well, the point that keeps occurring to me, Foggy, is that it's not exactly our ladder.
No, I mean, nobody's claiming it's our ladder. We're not taking it to be our ladder. We're merely moving it so it becomes the general public's ladder. Oh, that portion of the general public which keeps falling into the canal. Now, come on, give us a hand with it. Come on, give it off. Whee!
Oh, it's a scrap heavy thing.
There's the ladder. There's no time for that now. Come on. Oh, come on.
Look at him. Running about like a big girl. Lying around again. What's wrong with you two?
We were thinking about blood.
Oh, here, give me the bag. I'm no stranger to blood.
Oh, I like a bit of blood. I don't like pudding. Well, I do.
There's 14 dead.
Hey, they were only a shunt.
What do we need with 14 dead when we've got the town council?
Does that look like 14 dead?
Is there any blood?
There's none. It's all under control. Foggy's approaching him with his hand back.
To be motionless. Why is it that a million years of natural selection has produced a breed of men in these parts perfectly adapted to uselessness? They say it's a mystery why primitive man ever came down from the trees. Well, it's no mystery to me. If he were out like you lot, I expect the silly devil fell out.
Straight up and down. Well, not exactly straight, you know.
Is it swollen? How does it look?
Terrible.
No, they're having you on, Foggy. They're having you on. It's really quite horrible.
It isn't. How serious are
you? Panic. They were never much of a nose, anyway.
It was a classical nose. Oh, God, my nose. I was very happy with that nose. It was sort of early George Sanders.
Yeah, well, it's more like Colonel Sanders now. Oh, yes. That's real Kentucky Fried, is that?
I'm glad you find it amusing.
Oh, I don't suppose it's all that amusing. When you've been living in a little cafe like me all your life, you've got to be grateful for any little luck you can get.
It hurts. What I find appalling is that they struck me while I was under the Red Cross flag on an errand of mercy. By shooting down the flying doctor. Of course, I couldn't retaliate, could I? But I mean, you can't go around wielding your karate chop when you're under the Red Cross.
Karate chop? That looks more like a lamb chop.
Oh, Tom, they'd have been in trouble if I hadn't been protected by the Geneva Convention.
Well, that ends well.
But if all this ending well,
it's a small price to pay if it's put an end to any ambitions you might have for serving humanity.
Put an end to it? You don't think I'm going to be deterred by the first little setback?
Give us a tea, sir.
And me, tea. Oh, and one for the lady with the lamp.
Strange glass.
Look at the way he soaks that. just like my Auntie Connie's canary.
I didn't know your Auntie Connie had a canary.
Oh, yeah, she got it because she's scared of living on her own.
Oh, that's very sensible. Yeah, you wonder why more lonely widows don't think of that. Getting themselves the protection of a vicious canary. Is it trained to kill, is it? You know, one of your deadly Doberman canaries.
She keeps it for gas leaks. She's terrified of gas leaks.
Why didn't she get an electric canary?
Because she's poor. We're all poor in our family.
That's because you never went to work.
Listen, Elsie. When you're making a living being poor, it's very difficult to find the time to go to work.
That's an interesting viewpoint. The Simonite family didn't go into poverty with their eyes closed. They really thought about it.
No, we were very good at being poor. We were famous for it.
You were famous for not going to work. That's why you were poor.
No, I blame that on God.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Go on. Typical. Blame the Conservatives.
I remember when I were a young lad being strung out of this boozer.
But you didn't blame that on God, surely?
Not exactly.
I should hope not. You were always being thrown out of boozers.
It's true. There was one very, very irritating habit that landlords cannot stand.
What is that, we ask cautiously?
Having no money. So, after I picked myself up off the floor and made a meaningful gesture in the direction of the tap room, I went for a walk up the hill. Over a full moon.
Fascinating. Feels compelled to make meaningful gestures whenever there's a full moon.
They were very bright. What a lovely night. It was a bit too clear for ferreting. But you could see right down the valley. And I suddenly thought, there's that big fat moon up there. What am I doing down here with nobody? Whichever way you look at it, that is the major snag with being poor. Nobody. Then I heard myself saying, "Hey God, I hope you've got a convincing reason for me being Compo Simonite and not the Duke of Bedford.
Or even the Duchess of Bedford."
No. I've never had the slightest desire to be the Duchess of Bedford.
Well, that's good news for the Duke of Bedford. What's this then? Have I missed something? Is it National Swiss Week? Sit down if you're stopping. Am I? If you're not going to start yodeling. He's not going to start yodeling, is he? Sit down. Nobody's going to start yodeling. What do they do, you know? They yodel. You can see it on television. They're up there 2 minutes before they start yodeling.
Well, hang around, Wally. If you've got the time, we might get a drink.
Keep saying a little bottle down his neck. Very humorous, I'm sure.
Hey, how's your Auntie Connie's canary?
Oh, nicely, thank you.
Well, you knew about that, then.
Oh, yes. She's famous for her canaries, the Auntie Connie.
I keep telling them.
Keeps it for gas leaks.
She's of a very nervous disposition, is my Auntie Connie.
Gets the gas poured out every time the bird falls asleep.
So what do we owe the pleasure of this surprise visit?
Yes, I've been wondering about that one. How come Nora let you off the leash?
No, she sent me out. It's her idea. I'm completely legit. It's turning out to be a really magical Tuesday. It comes as a complete surprise to me. There she was shouting at me, saying, "Don't just stand there. Go out and get some help."
Help?
Ah, so I'm here. Oh, she wants some furniture lifting.
Well, Walt, do you fancy a drink?
Oh, aye, it's time for a drink.
Oh, blum.
She's not going anywhere. She's trapped under the bed.
How did you manage that, Wally?
Just lucky, I suppose. She went under after a speck of fluff, and she got back of a penny out on a spring.
Oh, can you lift the bed?
It's our marriage bed, a damn great thing. A bloke can get hernia struggling on his own with his marriage bed.
Hey, I'm Nora. Your worries should open up.
Oh, my God, it's not him, is it? It is. I know them willies anyway.
How do, Nora?
Keep away.
You look very attractive.
Where's my husband?
It suits you, you know, being fast under a bed.
Get me husband. I want me husband.
He's come in, love. He's showing Foggy his pigeon photos. Don't worry, love. I'll have you out of there in two shakes of whatever it is I can get hold of. Oh, the wrinkled stockings.
What are you doing here? You've no business to be here. Get away.
Nora, for future reference, just be careful where you put your boot. Very deceptive, is Nora. She's bigger than you think.
Come on, get out of the bed. One of these corners and I'll jump to it.
Yes, well, let me up. What a fool point to think with all these men in my bedroom.
Oh, well, if you keep quiet about it, Nora, we will.
Lift. Now, lift.
Boy, this is some sort of bed, is this? Oh, you need some stamina for a bed like this.
Our rescue drill. Right, come on. Right to him. Right. Let me see. What an excellent piece of rescue equipment this becomes in the right hands. I'll get on with it.
Why me? That's what I want to know. Why me?
About it. We've got all the responsibility.
You'd hate it here with all this responsibility.
I'll come back and strangle the first one that steps up, I tell you.
Nobody's going to step off. You've got by far the most interesting job.
You can tell by his face that he's got the most interesting job.
Thank you.